Hello everyone! I had a plan to discuss the dinosaur extinction by the meteorite who hit in Mexico. However, space decided to go a little bit crazy and letting just some rocks flying around. And in this video, we're going to discuss how you actually call those little rocks. We have a lot of different things flying around in space, like meteorites, comets, and so on. And before we start talking about the recent events, I would like to differentiate between those different kind of rocks. If we take a look into our solar system, the biggest thing, of course, we find is the sun, and then we have the planets, so this is quite easy. We have here, for example, the Earth. And then the next object that gets us a little bit closer to asteroids are so-called dwarf planets. Those planets have a high enough mass so that the gravity can actually pull things in and the planet itself can be round. If we then take a look at a smaller scale, we find so-called asteroids. Those are still pretty huge, however, they have not enough mass to get actually a round shape, so they are kind of stone-like. If we take a look into our solar system, we find a lot of asteroids in the asteroid belt. You find this one between Mars and Jupiter. And then at the edge of our solar system, you will find the Kuiper belt, who is again also made of a lot of asteroids. However, then we have also some comets. Those are from far away most of the times. And they're not made of rock, or at least partly of rock, but most of it is actually ice. So if you see them flying by the sun in their orbit, you will see that comets have kind of a tail that is pushed away from the comet itself by radiation from the sun. Most of the comets are coming from far away. It's assumed that we have a lot of additional comets around our solar system and they're lying in the so-called Oort cloud. However, no one has really observed them because we only see comets if they come close to us. Then we have one sort of big stone left that is flying around in space, and actually there's a lot of them, and those are called meteorites. Whatever, I can't pronounce them. But if you compare those with an asteroid, you will find that the meteorites are very, very small. So they have a diameter of 100 to 10 meters. However, there is no consensus reached at what size you call it a meteorite. Alright, now we have established the things that we find in space. And the most common thing to hit us is the meteoroids, those really, really tiny rocks. And a few days ago, the meteoroid called 2012 DA14 was supposed to pass very close by the Earth. And actually, it did do that, so it didn't hit us, which is quite lucky for us. However, it was only around 40 meters in diameter, so it wouldn't be like a big problem like when the meteorite hit the dinosaurs. Anyway, the really crazy thing that happened is that on the same day, from another side on the Earth, there was a meteorite crashing into Russia. And this one actually entered the Earth's atmosphere and is therefore called now a meteor. It's also called sometimes shooting star or falling star, but of course it's not a star, it's a meteoroid. This meteor was affected by a lot of friction with the air and got really, really hot. And in the end, in a few kilometers of height in the air, the meteor exploded because of the friction. And this actually caused quite a big shockwave that made the glass windows shatter over quite a big area, and actually over 1,000 people got hit by cuts with the glass. Fortunately, no one was killed, but actually the chances that you get hit by a meteorite are quite low. Once a meteor hits actually the Earth, the stone, it's called a meteorite. Alright, I think this video will be kind of awful, because my pronunciation is really not that great. However, the only thing I wanted to tell you with this video is that the big rock from space that actually hit the dinosaur is called an asteroid because it was quite big. And when it crashed into the Earth, it's called a meteorite. So now, as we have this sorted out, we can talk next week about dinosaur extinction. So, see you next week. Bye-bye.